Coming up after the news, I'm speaking to local celebs, stars of the Campbell Corona Diaries, TikTok mega sensations, the Campbell family. If you haven't heard of them before, I think you soon will. They're going on a huge quest around the world and they're telling us all about it. So stick with me. That's coming up after the news, which is coming up after this.
We're on a mission
to discover
if there's a better way.
Behind the scenes.
So for anyone who might know you guys, either like locally or maybe they have followed you on Instagram with your amazing Corona Diaries, which I loved. And of course, you are a bit of a TikTok sensation as well, Indie, which I am living for. So anyone who knows you, you seem to have quite a nice life. You live in Henley, you've got nice jobs, you seem to have a really big social circle, big close family, and it all looks pretty good. So why are you giving all that up?
That is a very, very good question. So it's something that Katie is quite asks me quite often, actually. But I think for best part of a decade, really, I have thought that there's a question in my mind about whether we're all living our lives the right way. And by that, I mean that, you know, we're very happy. But, you know, I think we're quite time poor in terms of being able to do the things that we really want to do more of. And in the society that we live in at the moment, there's this constant need to upgrade all the time. And I'm questioning whether that is the right way, because the model that we've all created is this idea that we all build our own castles. You know, the measure of success, you know, particularly, dare I say it, in the areas that we live, seems to be how big your gates are at the end of your drive. And that goes directly against some of the things that I've learned about in terms of social psychology and happiness, which says that actually the more embedded you are in a community, the more you feel that you're part of a community, the happier you are. And yet we seem to be going directly against that in terms of the fabric of our society and how we live. So what we're going to go and explore is we're going to open our hearts and minds to the way communities around the world live and behave that are perhaps a little bit more collective in their outlook. And the idea is that we haven't got the answers to the questions that I'm posing here. But I think that by embedding ourselves in these communities for a length of time, you know, probably a couple of months each time that we go to live in one of these communities, we're going to find out an awful lot about the way different communities live. And the idea is to then take all those learnings and come back to the UK and actually change the way that we live and actually create a communing, a co-housing community, an intentional living community, whatever you want to call it, that focuses on being more collective, being more efficient, being more sustainable. You know, what better time is there than the current time?
I was going to say that to you, because, I mean, for anyone listening might think, is this just a bit of a knee-jerk reaction because it's been a horrible year? Like, all of our lives have been thrown up in the air. We're all living so differently, not intentionally. But this isn't something that you've just gone, actually, let's just do this now. You've been thinking about this for a long time, haven't you? And I really liked your analogy, Campo. You were talking about the terrace, row of terrace houses.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's the analogy I always fall back on. The idea that, you know, we live in suburbia in Henley. It's absolutely lovely. But, you know, most of the houses are kind of identikit houses, right? And everyone's got pretty much the same strip of a garden out the back. And every single person's got a lawnmower. And we probably need one lawnmower. But because we are not collective and we don't talk to each other in that way, I mean, actually, COVID's brought everyone together much better, hasn't it? But, you know, we still aren't really collective in our outlook. And therefore, we're all buying things that in reality, we don't need all these things. It's just because we're not very collective in the way that we think. And therefore, we don't manage those things particularly well, in my humble opinion.
So what you could do is do something locally. You could just buy a lawnmower, mow your neighbour's garden. You could do something quite low-key, but you've thought, no, that seems a bit too easy. So this is the plan. You're in September this year, you're packing up your whole life and moving away for a year. Is that definite, or will you sort of see how it goes?
Yeah, I mean, that's the plan. Best part of a year. Obviously, it's going to be COVID. You know, COVID will maybe have something to say about that, but that's definitely the plan. And, you know, we think that it's going to be the most incredible adventure for the kids. You know, we're very lucky in the sense that Katie's a teacher. We've all got
not a primary teacher.
Not a primary teacher, no, no. But, you know, I think that the ages of the kids at the minute are just about perfect. It also ties into what I do. I make films. So the idea is that I create, a documentary, really, in relation to what we're doing and what we're trying to achieve. So, at the moment it feels quite scary because I've left my job and we're trying to get all the pieces of the jigsaw in place to make it all happen. But we're super confident that it is going to happen.
So you're going to go away. You're going to live with a number of different communities, as you say, focus much more on community living. Do you know who any of these communities are yet? Have you started making calls, or is that still open for discussion?
We have started. I've done a lot of research into lots of different communities. I think that we haven't landed upon exactly where we're going to go yet, because if we get a broadcast deal or anything like that, those things, other people might have something to say about where they want us to go. But kind of we'll definitely, I think, go to Scandinavia, where co-housing and community is very high up on the agenda, and it's kind of quite established. I think that we'll definitely go to the US, to maybe one of the more.
And how kind of remote would you go? I mean, will we see you like living with a tribe in the jungle?
Yes,
no electricity.
Yes. I think I will have to dig deep on that. But yeah, I think the idea is to put me out of my comfort zone a bit, and not just me, obviously everybody, but I think it's going to test me, that's for sure. But I think that's. Otherwise, there's no real point. It's not like, we can't just go on holiday. That's not the point.
Yeah.
Even though I'd obviously love to end up on a beach in Thailand or something like that. We've got to check out how the communities are.
You really have. And what are you most nervous about?
That's what you most
nervous
about.
What are you most nervous about?
Not seeing my friends.
Not seeing her friends. Yeah. I think that's it. That's
family.
I think missing people is going to be a real thing for us, because, like Katie has said in the past, we're not running away from anything here. We've got a really lovely life, and we love our friends and we love the community here in Henley. Just because there are these questions doesn't mean that we're not quite happy. But could we be happier? Is definitely a question, and that's a question that we'd like to try and answer by, opening up, as I say, our hearts and minds to other ways.
And you think that you're going to go away, you're going to, you don't know how this, you've said, you've been quite open, you don't know how it's going to end. It might be that you're like, actually, do you know what, we have a really nice life in Henley, let's just go back to living how we were. But you said that you kind of expect that at the very least you'll take some things. Could it be possible that you come back and open the Henley commune?
I think that's part two.
That's genuinely is the plan. So we're very big on roots, right, and we love the area that we're in, and if at all possible, the idea is to create a kind of co-housing environment in
around
and
all, here.
Around here, whereby you pool resources, and we kind of avoid that game that I think we're all in, which is the constant upgrade. It's the constant, where's our next house move going to be, etc. We actually lay down roots that are permanent, and there are some big social points to this. I think that as a society we've sleptwalked into a scenario where we feel completely comfortable putting all our old people in homes. Now that is not the way that it works across the world. It's just the system that we have now created in the UK. But we need to, in my view, I think we need to get back to more fellowship, more family, not just our you know, little family, but a bigger family, and looking after each other properly. And I think COVID again has really accentuated those problems that we've got at the moment. You know, we found all our old people in a global pandemic locked up. It's because, you know, we have as a society created that phenomena, and the phenomena is there because there's not enough time in our lives to look after our nearest and dearest. And as I keep saying, that's not the way that it is all around the world. And I just want to explore whether there is alternative options and whether we can look at those things around the world and bring some of those things back to the UK and get everyone to shift mindset a little bit.
I think it's really exciting. What do all your friends and family think of this? Are they all on board?
I think, as I've said before, Campo has been boring. It's probably not right, the phrase, but everyone, any dinner party for the last 10 years, they've, you know, everybody's heard this. Everybody's heard about the row of terrace houses. Everybody's heard about the lawnmower. And I think a lot of people are like, good on you. You have been going on about this for 10 years and now you're going to put your money where your mouth is and actually go and do it. And you know, lots of people might be listening to this thinking that they've always had a dream or something they've always said that they do. And not many people actually do it and actually try and do it. And so, you know, I have to take my hat off to him for making us do it, because I don't think I'd be the person that would, I'd be the one sitting there having a dream and then not doing anything about it. So, yeah, so I think, I think he's been talking about it for a long time. So it's a good thing to be involved.
I think it sounds amazing. And do you know what? I think, you know, you've said before that you will, at the very least, you'll be following along with, you know, on YouTube, but that, you know, you hope that this is something that might get picked up by, you know, a TV channel. And I think, I mean, this is so exciting. I think no one could help but be really interested and want to know what happens and follow you along the way. So girls, you're excited about this.
What are you most excited about?
Going on the airplanes.
Going on the aeroplanes, that's always the best bit of the trip, isn't it?
Yeah.
What are you, the excitement.
What are you excited about, Kiki?
Being excited, Kiki.
We'll take that as a yes.
So she is, she's thinking.
About seeing my friends.
Oh, seeing new friends. Yeah.
That would be great.
Indeed,
we're going to make so many new friends.
Are you excited about anything when we go away?
I think we've got some fairly big challenges on the broadcast front. I think that, you know, the perception of a white middle class family going off and kind of escaping is a bit of a problem that we're going to have to overcome. You know, so whether a broadcaster picks this up or not, we just don't know. But what we are going to make sure we do one way or another is document the journey, whether that be through our own YouTube channels or whether that be in some other way online, or whether it be via a broadcaster. It will 100% be documented, because that's what I do.
You've already got a lot of interest. How many subs have you got on YouTube?
How many subs? Well, we've been going just 2 weeks, and we've got over a thousand, I think 1,100, something like that, in a couple
that's
of weeks.
Really good.
Yeah, so that's great, and you know, we really need that to grow, because without that growing, it's going to make this very, very difficult. If there's anyone out there that thinks that they can help us in any way, shape or form in terms of growing our channels, we'd love to hear from you.
Yeah, absolutely. And if people want to follow along, because what's really nice about this, you're sort of thinking you'll do it in September, but people can follow along on YouTube as you plan it and kind of the challenges that you will no doubt face as you're planning it. Yes. So how can people find you on all the socials?
Well, it's pretty much Communing with the Campbells across all our socials. So that's on Instagram, that's on YouTube, TikTok. If you just search that, you will find us.
You are very popular on TikTok, thanks to Indy. How many views and likes you've had? You've had thousands and millions, in fact, you've had views on one of the vids, haven't you?
Yeah, she's had a couple of million views on one particular video on TikTok. So she's turned into a little bit of a TikTok sensation, all by complete accident, by the way. We're embracing it, because why not?
Indy, Indy, what is your favourite animal?
A panda.
A panda. It's not a tiger.
Panda.
She's changed it.
What's a tiger?
Yeah. Oh.
A tiger. So thank you so much, guys, for coming on and telling us. As I said, I mean, fingers crossed, when things return to normal, will you come into the studio and have another chat with us and update us on your progress?
We would love that. Would you like to see that?
Yeah. And I asked you girls what your favourite songs are, and we're going to play them in just a minute. Sorry, were you going to say something, Campo?
No, I don't think I was.
Wow.
No,
you are. but I asked the girls for their favourite songs. So, Tati and Kiki, tell us what songs you both chose.
Black Magic from Little Mix.
Yes. And what one did you choose, Kiki?
A Million Dreams
from Greatest Showman, which I tell you what, both those songs I play on the show all the time anyway, so you've got excellent taste. Guys, good luck with it all, and we can't wait to watch along.
Oh, thank you, Amelia.
Thank you so much for your support, Amelia.
Thank you, guys. Take care. So here we go. This one chosen by Tati. This is Little Mix and Black Magic.
Next time on Communal with the Campbells.
Hello. Did you have fun?
Yeah.
Come on in. Come on in.